106 of the most beautiful girls, all representing their country and all in outfits designed by Miss World 1975, Wilnelia, Lady Forsyth Johnson, on a beach, on a tropical island, with seemingly hundreds of camera operators and assistants milling around. It was certainly an extraordinary introduction to the whole Miss World experience. The next morning I was taken to a small theatre in the less salubrious part of town to meet with all the girls who were going to take part in the talent show. All went well, and after a couple of days of honing and coaching, we filmed it. There were a few girls who could dance really well, a couple of singers and a magician, so the mix was quite fun. Bruce Forsyth was also there to support Wilnelia, and he couldn't help himself. Suddenly, he wasn't just an adjudicator, he was also tap dancer in chief on stage as well. His inherent talent in front of a crowd always at the ready, even a crowd that only spoke Chinese. All was going well, and I was getting ready for the 24-hour flight home on the next day, when out of the blue, Ken Warwick came to meet me in somewhat of a panic. "Mike, the music that was commissioned for the show really doesn't work, and we need walk-down music for all the girls for the beginning of the live final. But we need the music to rehearse with them tomorrow. Is there any way that you can help?" Well, quite by chance, I had taken a small MIDI keyboard and my laptop with me, so I naturally said yes and that I would give it a go. I asked for a framework to work with, tempo, bar counts, that sort of thing, and overnight I wrote and made a little demo of a 4-minute piece, and at 8:30 a.m, an hour before I needed to leave to catch my plane, I played it to Kenny and his choreographer, the legendary dancer Donna Darby, in my hotel room from my computer. Fortunately, they loved the concept and it was approved. It was the bare bones with enough rhythm and melodic information on the track for Donna to work with, so I hastily bounced it down to a CD, hightailed it for the airport with the promise that I would get the finished piece to them in the next few days after I had returned home. After no sleep, I was very relieved that it was the right sort of thing, and though I didn't finish until I did get home, I still found enough time, while I was waiting for my plane connections, to add quite a lot of flesh to those bare bones in transit.